It is 2:37 p.m. this Wednesday, October 26th, 2022. In this section of track, getting a dusting right now. From the Herzog Plus Cars programmable linear unloading system. The movable doors allow just the exact amount of stone to be added. Alongside the rail itself on top of the cross ties, a tamper will tamp this stone in, including on the ends of the ties, and the regulator will groom it one more time. This half of the train still has full cars. Thirty-five cars on this AFW2. A good look at the stone being applied evenly to the right of way. Used to be that when you tipped the door, the stone cascaded out, and the conductor needed to relay to the engineer how fast to move the train. Now instead, you just keep the train at a steady speed, and the guy walking along opens and closes the door. The difference. Tops of the ties are dusted in. Brand new ballast. Good look at it right now. You can see the switch for the new Indrio team close to us, and the West Main that they are rocking in right now behind it. That is a great shot from right here from my front door. This train will continue to ballast in this West Main and will move north 2 miles to 232 crossover to to get back onto the east main. Otherwise, they'd be trapped on a stub end rail, not be able to get back to Fort Pierce. You can see the 507 down here. It's a GP38-2. And the 510 is on the other end of this train, with the going places in Florida, sometimes mistakenly called a hurricane logo, emblazoned on its flank. We're going to get photobombed right here. Glad to see them. Thank you very much. Yard waste day. The time now is 2:45 p.m. this Wednesday, October 26th, 2022. We'll see this train again two more times, once going north on this track, and then once going south when they cross over to the East Main. You can hear the engineer throttling that engine as he moves the controller notch to notch. It's going to do it from MP236 on the Florida East Coast Main Line.